The Mini 3 or Mini 3 Pro still has a couple of big advantages over the newest Air 3. But if you're wondering if you should upgrade or if you should buy one or the other, today I want to break down all the differences between these two drones to help you decide which one of these drones might be the right drone for you. The Mini 3, Mini 3 Pro is a great little drone, and its biggest selling point is that with the right batteries, you're under 249 grams, which means you don't have as many restrictions or as many issues with rules and laws in various places around the world because it's so small and so lightweight. Doesn't mean you can fly it or do whatever you want with it, but it does mean you might not have to adhere to as many rules and as many restrictions as anything with a larger drone. So with a top speed of about 33 miles an hour and then a top ascent and descent speed of about 11 miles an hour, the Mini 3 or Mini 3 Pro does a great job. You get about 31 minutes of flight time with the battery that keeps this whole drone under 249 grams. Now, if you want to get the full 47 minutes of flight time, which you can get with the heavier battery, then you're over 249 grams, which means you're over that special weight limit that keeps you under some of those restrictions. However, neither one of those are real time. I mean, you're realistically talking maybe 24 minutes on the lightweight battery and 35 to 36 minutes on the heavier battery. You're never gonna get that full amount because there's always some left over you have to land at some point. For video specs, this will shoot 4K up to 60 frames a second, and it will also shoot vertical video, 4K up to 60 frames a second, where it actually rotates the entire gimbal so that you get a true vertical video format. And you can take 12 or 48 megapixel stills because it's a quad bayer system. And of course, with all of the newest DJI drones, you have lots of smart shots, quick shots, smart tracking features, master shots, stuff like that. But when it comes to active track, the Mini 3 has no obstacle avoidance. The Mini 3 Pro is the only one that does. So it's the one that has obstacle avoidance. However, it is only forward and rear facing obstacle avoidance and some downward obstacle avoidance. There's no side. So if you're going to be tracking from the side or tracing yourself, then you're going to run into obstacles if you're not careful. Now, the newest drone on the market is the Air 3 from DJI, and it is a powerhouse. It has two cameras now, a 1x 24 millimeter field of view and a 3x or 70 millimeter field of view. Both of them are the 1/1.3-inch sensor, which means you get really good low light. They are both capable of shooting 4K up to 60 frames a second, which is fantastic. And you can take 12 or 48 megapixel stills because it's a quad bayer system. This drone has a top speed of 46 miles an hour. It climbs at almost 19 miles an hour, 18 something miles an hour, which is fast. And then it descends at a crazy 22 miles an hour, which is insanely fast and a little bit terrifying if you're not used to it. But this drone will go places really fast and then go up or down really, really quickly as well. And a couple of big improvements they made over the previous generation of the Air series is that this one now has 360 obstacle avoidance, which means when you're tracking yourself from the front, from the side, from behind, anything like that, this drone has obstacle avoidance that's aware of its complete surroundings around it completely. And it also has a 46 or 47 minute flight time, which means realistically 30 something, 35, 36 minutes. Although I've really actually seen 38 minutes, 39 minutes, which is pretty crazy considering if I'm pushing the battery right to the very end. And like most DJI drones now, it has lots of smart features, lots of quick shots, master shots, all of those kinds of things. If you want to get just some really great footage of yourself without having to learn and fly the drone yourself. Jumping into the differences between these two drones, the biggest one that you're gonna notice right away and the biggest advantage of the Mini 3 is the size and weight. This drone is ideal if you're somebody who does a lot of backpacking, hiking, where you want the absolute smallest drone package that you can possibly get, the lightest drone package that you can possibly get to squeeze in a camera bag or a backpack or something like that and take video and photo of yourself when you're out exploring like I do here in Alaska. The other biggest advantage of the Mini 3 over the Air 3 is that it's under 249 grams if you use the lighter weight battery. That means you don't have to deal with a lot of the regulations that a larger, heavier drone will have to deal with. That, on the other hand, though, can be the biggest disadvantage with the Air 3 is that it moves around in the wind a lot. And so if you're in a place where the wind is blowing, I am today, you can see how much more the DJI Mavic Mini 3 moves around in the wind, which means you can see it in the footage as you can see here. So that is the biggest disadvantage to this as well. I mean, there's other advantages and disadvantages, but that is the biggest one. And that's the reason that I don't use the Mini 3, because most places that I'm going, most hikes that I do, it's fairly windy and I just could not ever get as smooth a footage as I was hoping for. For video specs, these both shoot 4K 60. That's really great 4K 60 overall. There is one big caveat though, and that's that the Mini 3 and Mini 3 Pro only shoot in D-Cine-like, whereas the Air 3 will shoot in D-Log M on both cameras. And that is a huge advantage if you're trying to match the footage from one of your drones up to other cameras. The D-Log M is just a much more much flatter, much more log-like profile, so it gives you a lot more leeway in post. And dare I say, the Air 3 has a bit more dynamic range than the Mini 3 Pro, even though it seems like they should have about the same. The Mini 3 can also shoot slow motion 1080p up to 120 frames a second. The Air 3, on the other hand, can shoot slow motion 4K up to 100 frames a second and 1080p up to 200 frames a second, which is quite a bit better if you like filming or videoing slow motion stuff. While both of these drones will film vertical video, they take a different approach. The Mini 3 actually flips the entire gimbal so you get the full resolution in a vertical format, whereas the Air 3 instead does a crop so you get up to 2.7K in a vertical format. I find that I prefer the Air 3 because you still see more when you're flying on the sides, but if you're doing a lot of vertical content, the Mini 3 actually might be the better drone for you. Both of these drones are capable of doing 12 or 48 megapixel stills, but I feel like the Air 3's quality is just a bit better. It's hard to quantify, but in editing the photos, I do feel like the Air 3 is just a little bit better. Now, they both can do panoramics, they both can do spherical photos, they both can do wide angle photos, all those. So if you're taking photos, either one of these drones does really well. But the Air 3, the quality of the raw photos especially, is just a bit better, and there definitely is a little bit more dynamic range there. Another place the Air 3 stands way above the Mini 3 or the Mini 3 Pro is the speeds. 46 miles an hour versus 33 miles an hour, maybe 35 miles an hour, depending on the conditions you're flying in. But then being able to climb at 18 miles an hour versus 11, maybe 12 miles an hour, and descend at double the speed of the Mini 3 at 22 miles an hour, that is a substantial difference. And if you're needing to get the drone into places quickly to get a shot, or get the drone out of the air quickly because, you know, maybe there's an airplane coming or something like that, the Air 3 is substantially faster and substantially more robust. But also, because it's a larger, heavier drone, it does not move around in the wind nearly as much as the Mini 3 does. And so you'll notice a big difference in your footage if you fly a lot in windy places like I do. And of course, on the video and photo fronts, the Air 3 has two cameras and two lenses, one being 24, which matches up with the Mini 3, but then the other one, the 3X at 70 millimeters, really gives you some wild opportunities to compose your shots differently. And it will also active track and do all the smart features in that 3X lens, which gives you huge opportunities to compose shots differently, especially if you're wanting to fly and get closer shots of things like wildlife or something like that, where you don't actually want to get that close to wildlife and disturb them, then the Air 3 is a fantastic drone. And one more advantage that the Air 3 has over the Mini 3 or Mini 3 Pro is that the Air 3 has the new night mode, which gives it substantially better performance in low light. Now, the Mini 3 does actually do pretty well in low light because it has a very open aperture of f1.7. However, the night mode out of the Mavic 3 or the Air 3 is just substantially better. It's really incredible the performance that they've been able to get out of these drones in incredibly low light conditions. So if you plan on filming a lot in low light, then the Air 3 is definitely gonna be the way to go. Another thing to note about both of these drones is that both of their gimbals are capable of tilting up to 60 degrees in an up tilt, which means you can get these really cool looking up shots and fly forward in sport mode without ever worrying about the gimbal actually bottoming out or reaching its end of range of motion. And another difference between these two is the sound and the noise levels between these two drones. Here's an example of each one of these drones' noise levels. Or another big change between these two drones is that you have Occusync 4 and Occusync 3. Now, at first, that might not seem like a big difference, but there's a huge difference in how far you can go, way beyond visual line of sight. But the biggest difference is when you've got obstacles or very dense RF environments like cities. You're gonna see a massive difference with the Air 3 over something like the Mini 3 or Mini 3 Pro because of that Occusync 4 and something else that they made a change with the controllers. Another difference that they made with the controllers, if you get the Fly More kit with the DJI RC, is that The DJI RC2 has both external antennas and internal antennas, where the DJI RC only has internal antennas. That might not seem like a big deal, and it doesn't affect everybody that much, but if you're in places like the European Union, where the output power of the transmitter is much more limited than here in the US, then as soon as you're in an RF-dense environment or in areas where there's trees or things like that that you might be moving behind between you and the drone, you're gonna see a big difference in performance. And that performance also comes from the fact that there's only a couple of antennas in the Mini 3 and there are 6 antennas in the Air 3, which means you get a lot better performance as far as your transmission distance, and especially in where there's obstacles or a lot of other RF interfering with the drone's control signals and video signals. I said that one of the biggest advantages of the Mini 3 is its size and weight, and that is true so long as you're using the lightweight battery. But as soon as you step up to something that has more weight to it, that basically matches up the same flight time between these two, that advantage is gone because it's over 249 grams, at least as far as regulations go. Now, it's still a much smaller, much lighter weight drone than the Air 3. So if you're backpacking, then it's gonna be the one that you really like, unless you're in very windy situations a lot of the times. Another way the Air 3 is very superior to the Mini 3 or Mini 3 Pro is the Air 3 has a fan. So if you operate in places where there's a lot of hot weather, not like me, not here, but in places where you do get hot weather, then the Air 3 is gonna be able to hold up and substantially better in those conditions because it has a fan for internal cooling of the electronics. Whereas the Mini 3 relies completely on forward flight and a little bit of air being pushed through these back vents here with the propellers. But in really hot conditions, the Mini 3 is gonna struggle quite a bit more than the Air 3 will. And then it comes down to price. The Mini 3 with no obstacle avoidance comes in at $550-ish with the regular RC, and then the Fly More combo comes in at a little over $700. Then we have the Mini 3 Pro, which comes in at $750-$760 with the regular RC controller, or if you want the Mini 3 Pro with the DJI RC, the one with the screen, that'll come in at about $900. There is no Fly More combo with that, but you can get the Fly More and the Fly More Plus kit for $190 or $250 respectively, depending on if you want the longer, heavier flight time batteries or the shorter batteries. And then we come to the Air 3, which starts at $1,099 and the Fly More combo going up to $1,550-ish, depending on what you want and depending on which remote controller you want. There's a couple of different options there, but it's definitely a fair bit more, but you do get substantially more performance for that price. All in all, the Air 3, not surprisingly, is quite a bit better performing drone. It's quite a bit larger, is just a lot more features, not surprising and shouldn't be. It's also more expensive. The Mini 3, still fantastic in most conditions and definitely if you deal with harder regulations with drones. I'm curious, let me know in the comments below if you own one or the other or if you're buying one or the other, and definitely you can use my links in the description if you are going to buy and you want to help support this channel through the affiliate links. But in the meantime, you're going to want to watch this video right here. I'll see you over there. As always, if you have questions, ask me in the comments below, or you can join my live stream, which happens most Wednesday nights at 4 p.m. Alaska time, 8 p.m. Eastern, or we can have a bit more of a conversation, or I can hopefully answer questions that maybe I didn't answer in this particular video. I will see you again soon in the next video. Cheers.